Yeah. So now I'm going to show you something which has never been shown. This is a case of absorbed nucleus with zonular dehiscence. What I'm going to do is do the normal capsulorhexis after taking the help of the cystitome. Then see, at this point you will realize that there is a zonular dehiscence. I am going to do the direct chop, and with this direct chop, what is going to happen is I am going to separate the nuclear pieces. Now I know that there is some zonular dehiscence. So I am going to keep these nuclear pieces in place, because this hard nucleus will be used as a scaffold for the first time. How I am going to do it? Here again, when I am going to hold it, I find that there is some zonular dehiscence. So now my plan is to give some support to the bag. Either I go in for a capsular hooks or I go in for a CTR. I decide to go in for a CTR to give the horizontal support. Start from the area of zonular dehiscence. What about the anterior posterior support? The nucleus piece, mark my words, the nucleus piece are going to give the anterior posterior support. I place it there, use the nucleus piece as a scaffold for the first time to avoid zonular dehiscence in that area. Now this nuclear piece is giving an anterior posterior support, and the CTR is giving the horizontal support. This is continuing. Now it is not giving, so I reposition and I use a nuclear scaffold again to give the support. Now comes the next thing. What next to do in this case? I decide to use a lens as a scaffold. After the nuclear scaffold, now it is the IOL scaffold. Position it here, and after you have positioned it, now you can emulsify. So in this case, a nucleus has been used as a scaffold, and here I note that there is a peaking of the pupil. I keep away from the point so that the vitreous doesn't come. I use the repositor to take care of the vitreous tag, use the pilocar, and when I use I use the triamcinolon to take care to stain the vitreous. Vitrectomy is done, and the case which seemed hopeless, and using new innovations for the first time, now I am rechecking and I find that I've been able to put it through. Now comes the next case. In the next case, this is a patient who has fluid misdirection syndrome. This comes in our life once in a while. The case started in the routine manner. I was talking with the patient, and the patient was also talking with me, because this was the second eye and the patient was very comfortable. The nucleus emulsification carried out in the routine way. When the IA started, I suddenly realized that the posterior capsule had become flat. Now it was becoming convex. There was paucity of space in the anterior chamber. I decide at this stage, enough is enough. I take it out, and you will see that there is burping of visco. So there is a hard eye now. Either it is a suprachoroidal leak, or there is a fluid misdirection syndrome. I think again, and I say, why not put an IOL and as a scaffold and see if I can do. The iris starts coming out. I go through the side port, push it down. The vitreoretinal support at this point of time is not available. Now the question is, what should I do next? I think that what I should do now is I should put air. After putting the iris back into place, it is still hard. What to do? Somehow I am able to put air. Had a vitreoretinal support been there, I could have put a trocar and done a vitrectomy, and the fluid which would have been misdirected would have come out. I give IV mannitol, get the fundus examination done, get it ruled out, and find that it is back to normal. The case is continued, and without any issues, we have the best results. I think it's high time the work speaks rather than talking more about how I'm going to become the king. Thank you very much.